You're not making very good video, you keep turning around. Feeling that walking thing. They haven't shown where people walk and sit around. Race walk and sit around, and what's up with that? It's probably better for you, maybe. Gotta make some room here, people. Guy just skating.
Sir!
Fuck! What the hell is that? Just steps right into my path and never looks.
I don't know.
couldn't imagine stepping onto a roadway without looking. They do it all the time here. It's insane. Do I really want to go down here? This looks awful narrow. I don't. I'm gonna cut over. You gotta watch these tree limbs, man, they'll nail ya. See all those cameras and lights over there? That's the Imperial Palace over there. These guys are guarding it. Konnichiwa. These are all cherry trees. Really beautiful in the springtime during Hanami. Pretty low. I have Odin. So boy, I have Odin at home to eat. So call your mom and eat some Odin tonight. Everybody finds this camera fascinating. Kind of funny. This is like technology city here, and yet you don't really see so many GoPros here. Let's see, I want to go across and to the left. To the right, rather. Meet. Wait a minute, I think I made this mistake before. Let's see what happens. some ways, Tokyo reminds me of those car setups I used to make when I was a kid, where I would build like little HO cars. I'd build the roadways and all of that stuff. And this kind of looks like a miniaturized, or that's a miniaturized version of what this looks like, because it's very intense.
Let's look at this.
It's like the slowest light ever. Imperial Palace walls right there. There's those cute little girls. Must be their moms. Awesome. That is not far around at all. You really need to do the Yamanote line though.
Do we
white dog, pink shirt, pretty awesome. Looks like they're doing some work on the ginkgo. Still alive, I guess we're gonna do something to him.
I don't know, I didn't die.
So this is a loop around the Imperial Palace, basically. Very popular, obviously, for running and not so much for biking. See, we started at Sakura Moon Gate, so let's finish at Sakura the Moon Gate. We're kind of in front of the palace now, between the palace and downtown Tokyo. This one kind of the northeast side. There's the entrance to the East Gardens. Seems like most people run. What would that be? It would be a counterclockwise direction here. Yeah, I'd say almost nobody running the other direction, which is good. We're not banging into each other. I should come out here and train, actually, for the Ichikawa Marathon. that. Isn't that nice? That's another entrance to these cars, but they have it blocked off. Oh, that's fantastic. Are you going fast enough? Girls. It's funny, if they see you looking at them, they look away, but if you don't look at them, they look at you like, what the heck? Look at that sunset. This is new construction. So you gotta learn Japanese. Alright, so we're gonna go up here and cut through, and we are back to where we started. So this is kind of the main entrance for people that are walking to the Imperial Palace, which is only open twice a year. Both times on the Emperor's birthday. I'm sorry, once on the Emperor's birthday, which is towards the end of December, like the 26th or 27th. And then January the 2nd. Those are the only two times you can actually go to the palace itself. Which is surprisingly modern looking. There's the main entrance. There is a Shinobaze Bridge, the very famous picturesque place that people take the picture in front of. Then there's an iron bridge behind it that most people don't notice. So that's the main entrance, and if you look to the left, that goes down to the main Tokyo area, Tokyo Station, Marunouchi, and eventually Ginza. So you can see Shinobaze Bridge right there. So actually, we're going to make a right up here and go through Sakadramon Gate and go back to where we started. So this is a complete bike loop around the Imperial Palace in Tokyo, Japan. This is how it looks on a Sunday afternoon. January, I guess 11th or 12th, I don't know, I don't have a calendar. Nor do I care. 2014. Alright. So basically it's a lot of people running. A lot of cute Japanese girls. I suppose cute Japanese guys if that's what you like. The weather's fantastic. I mean it's cold. Which is good because Tokyo can be really, really hot starting like March. Up until November. Hey, got a smile, boy. I should ride this every Sunday, actually. It's a good ride. Put this in my to-ride list. So Sakadramon Gate is kind of interesting because it's two gates, and it was built for defensive. By the way, these bike cops are really hard-ass here. Anyway. It's for defensive purposes, and it's actually two gates at a 90 degree angle. And the reason it is if you have the movement of troops coming from the other gate, a large movement, if that whole group has to make a right-hand turn, say if they come through that gate there, have to make a right-hand turn, it's obviously difficult and confusing. So that's why it's not a straight shot. They actually did this 90 degree angle on purpose. And the doors, I mean, look at the doors, they're just amazing. Incredible doors. But I'm pretty sure they don't have to worry about getting invaded anymore. So this is back to the beginning. This is Sakura the Moon Gate at the Imperial Palace. And we just did a complete bike around. And keep in mind, I offer bike tours. So go to tokyobikingtours.com if you want to book one. All right, tokyobikingtours.com. And I'll show you this, or I've got another one, which is the waterfront tour, which is really awesome. Okay. Jamatane, kyotsukite ne. All right, guys, hope to see you soon. This is your Tokyo correspondent, Noel Curry, from reporting from Tokyo, Japan. Over and out.